again, everybody. I'm Jim Lampley. Certain athletes are born enemies. Bird and Magic, Ali and Frazier, Nancy Kerrigan and Tonya Harding. But the fiercest rivalry was between two fighters from Pittsburgh with the names Razor and Kid.
The fight of the year. Both men exhausted.
1982, Pittsburgh. Razor and Kid, both undefeated top-ranked contenders, divide the city in a spectacular war.
Now Kid smelling blood, punishing Razor with a relentless kill. And down goes Razor. Down goes Razor. Down goes Razor.
The brutal 15-round bout is still considered one of the greatest fights of the 80s. Kid and Razor quickly rose to superstardom, and the man behind their meteoric ascent was the late fight impresario, Dante Slate.
My dad was king of the ring and bringer of the bling. And that makes me royalty, blessed with all his powers.
Really good, Dante, but don't look into the camera. Just look at me.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I think it's a lot better when I'm connecting straight with the people.
Yeah, I really don't think...
What's up, people?
As the world clamored for a rematch, Slate knew that ratings would turn to dollar signs for both fighters.
What a turn of events! Unbelievable!
The rematch drew the biggest television audience since the thriller in Manila 9 years earlier. But this time the story was different. Razor soundly defeated Kid in a lopsided victory that was over in 4 rounds. What lay ahead was the tie-breaking grudge match that would have brought each fighter millions. Then came an announcement that shocked the world.
Today I'm announcing my retirement from professional boxing.
The man's a coward. I'm gonna get my rematch with this motherfucker. You hear me, Razor? I'm getting my rematch.
Sharp has declined to comment further on his decision to this very day. And sadly, like many former professional athletes, he lost his fortune just years after his retirement. Razor went back to Benson Shipbuilders in 1987, where he had worked before he went pro. As the spotlight faded, Kid became a pitchman for everything from jockey to Jock Itch.
Today, he runs a successful car dealership and a popular restaurant in Pittsburgh. Still, one can almost imagine him tonight on the 30th anniversary of the fight that never was, contemplating yet another year of growing older, obsessed with a fight that never happened and never will.
Yeah, just for the record, I never had Jock Itch. I'm just a great actor.